G'day ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Draw with Jazza. I'm Jazza and this is a video on painting in Photoshop. I've done a lot of painting in Photoshop tutorials in the past and I kind of had a different method that I've sort of moved past and I'm trying new things, and this is a style and a method that is a little more difficult to pull off, but I really feel like the results are more organic and really cool. So I want to go through that with you and hopefully make it accessible to those of you who are still learning. So using this sketch as a base, what I'm going to do is start setting up a bit of a foundation area for my painting. To do this, I'm going to make my sketch slightly more transparent, bring it down to let's say 30% opacity, and I'm going to add a layer underneath, zoom in, and with a really solid brush, with a really hard edge, I'm just going to grab a random color. It can be gray, it can be green, it actually really doesn't matter. And I'm now going to, on this new layer, outline the silhouette of the thing I'm going to paint. Now in this case, I'm painting just the character and the brush, so I'm actually going to leave the PS of the Photoshop symbol in the background and I'll deal with that later. And really that's all I'm doing right now, I'm just outlining the silhouette of this character. So I've got my silhouette done, that's all I needed to do, and now I'm going to grab my magic wand and select right in the middle of my silhouette, go select, modify, expand, and I want to expand my selection by 4 or so pixels, right click and fill, and I want to fill it with the foreground color, and essentially that just makes it all one solid block of silhouette. Now that we've got the silhouette, we're going to get to the first stage of the actual painting. So in our rough painting phase, what I want to do is create a layer above this silhouette that I've made, and I'm going to alt click between these two layers, and this, as you can see when I do that, it attaches it kind of with this little arrow to that layer. This is called a clipping mask, and it means that anything I do, whether it be paint with a big brush in the middle of it, no matter how much I go over the lines, it's only going to stay in that area. Now that's quite useful, because what we're going to do now is start adding the very base colors. I'm also going to start using brushes that I want to paint with. There are lots of different default brushes that come in Photoshop. You can right click and you can scroll down and see all these different default brushes. You can also find that area by clicking up here on the top left. But what I'm going to be using are some custom brushes, and you can buy these elsewhere. You can also download them. And these ones are made by Kyle T. Webster. I'm going to provide the link to them in the description, and they're absolutely fantastic. I believe he has like a sample pack where you can try bits of all of his brush sets, and they're really worth just mucking around with. But for now, what I'm going to be using is the Kyle Ultimate Oil Lush brush. And basically when I paint with it, it looks like this. And you can see it looks a lot more organic than just that random default brush that Photoshop has. So when I paint that, whether soft or hard, I can get this really nice brush-like texture. So I'm just going to delete that. I was just demonstrating it. But using this brush, I'm going to start blocking the areas of color. Now to simplify the process for myself, what I've done is I've made the hotkeys for making the brush smaller and larger, G and H. That's mainly because I'm used to that from my editing programs and things like that. So you can do it however you want. You can also right click and change the size here. So that's quite simple, but I've just tried to do it and keep it all on the keyboard. So selecting the very base color, no shade, no highlight, just kind of the middle ground color of the areas you're going to paint. So for example, here I've got the blue and I'm just going to roughly paint it in that area where it's going to be blue. Now, keep in mind, this is very rough. This is very loose. This is the ugly phase of painting, as my art teacher used to say. So here where I have the brush bristles, I am painting this sort of bristly color, and I'm not being too careful. It doesn't matter that this is all on the one layer. It doesn't matter if I go over the blue, select a silver, really roughly paint in that area, select a reddish hue for the wood, and then just kind of roughly paint in the handle. I'll use my hotkeys to make the brush size bigger. And as you can see, it's actually pretty quick that I just get in some really rough color base without being too refined. I'm really just getting in the basics, and that doesn't matter if I go over lines or edges or anything like that. There you go, ladies and gentlemen, I've completed phase one. This is the ugly phase of the painting. All I'm doing is getting in the real basics, the core bits of it. And it's all on one layer, that doesn't matter. So the next part is where I actually start to bring it about and start doing all this painting stuff I'm talking about. So I make a new layer, and it doesn't have to be part of the clipping mask, and it can be if you want it to be. I'm going to add it to be part of the clipping mask, and to do that, I'm just gonna again alt click between the line dividing the two layers, one that is already in the clipping mask and the one that I'm adding. Now with my brush selected, I'm going to work on the green area, and this is the one that I'm gonna kind of take you through the process of, because this is one of the most prominent areas of this character. So here's a quick tip for you. This is really fantastic and you're gonna wanna use it all the time. Hold Alt and click, and there you go. That's basically my eyedropper. I have selected this green color. So now when I paint it, I've got my green. If I Alt click, I select white, Alt click back to green. Now this is gonna be really useful because what I'm gonna do is create a palette. Now on a new layer, separate to the clipping mask, I'm just gonna paint that green there, okay? Now I'm going to use my color picker, find a darker green, and this is gonna be my shadow. Now something to keep in mind when you're choosing your shadows and highlights is you don't actually need to stay in the exact same color range. In fact, it adds a lot of dynamic feel to your painting if you move around here on your slider. So for example, if I wanna add a touch of warmth to the shadows of this character, I'm gonna move this slider down so it's got just a touch of yellow in it, and then hit okay, and then I'm gonna paint there, and you can see I've got these two different green colors now. One is my shadow and one is my highlight. This will act as my palette. I can add to it and take away from it, and that just means that as I go back to my layer and my clipping mask and start painting and lose my original color, it doesn't really matter because I've got my original colors over here on my palette that I can alt click and select. In this second phase of painting, we're gonna start focusing on shadows and highlights. We're gonna start to be a little more controlled with our brush size and how accurate we are and clean our lines are, but we're really not gonna be perfect yet. We're gonna get to that in our third phase. So I'm just gonna start really softly painting in the green areas that are gonna be shadowed. Now you'll notice that I'm not being very precious about keeping a clean line between my other areas of color. So for example, I'm painting over the eyes, which are white, and for example, here with the brush, I'm just gonna focus on doing the shadow of the green and not worry about the teeth, not worry about the brush stem or anything like that. I'm ignoring everything but my green area. It's very loose and we're covering broad areas. So I'm kind of doing the whole shape of the body. And as you can see, I've already added kind of this dimension of shade, and it's very loose, it's very messy, that doesn't matter, that's okay, relax. Next, I'm going to go darker. So I'll select my color picker, find a darker color, maybe add a touch more yellow. Remember to add it to my swatch at the start of it all so I can go back to it later and then go back into my clipping mask area. And now I'm going to start adding this darker color. I'm gonna use it more sparingly and kind of spread it out. We don't wanna get too dark too quickly. I wanna start using it just kind of at the very edges. And now we can also start using our shades and highlights to divide areas that are kind of blended. So if I hide my line work, you can see that this arm here actually isn't very well defined. Whereas if I make my brush nice and small, I can just kind of paint in the edge and paint in the edge there. It doesn't matter that it's messy. I'm just kind of setting a boundary now and I can work around that. And I can do the same here for the fingers and for the mouth and the rest. So I've added two different shadow colors. I'm gonna muck around with a bit of a highlight now. So I'm gonna alt click on my original green and I'm gonna go up here into a lighter green and I'm gonna go down here into the yellowish area again just to add a touch of that warmth. Add this color to my swatch so I can go back to it, and then back in my clipping mask, very lightly pick some areas to kind of bring out. We wanna be sparing with this, we don't wanna be over the top, but we do need to keep in mind that where there's a shadow, there's a highlight. Now, believe it or not, I've finished the second phase of my painting. So I'm actually ready to do the refining and moving on. Now, normally when I'm painting, I will do the whole image at once. So once I do the rough shades and highlights of this area, I would go on and do the same with the brush and with the pants and all that stuff. But I'm just gonna focus on the skin for now. Now, before I get to the refining phase, I'm gonna start doing a bit of cleanup. So I'm just gonna hit E, which is my shortcut for an eraser. And I'm just gonna erase and clean up this middle area a bit where the brush is. I'm just gonna start to kind of control things a little more than I have been. Again, it's not perfect and it doesn't have to be, that's actually kind of the point. But the fact that this is all on one layer, my simple highlights and shadows, even though they're messy, makes this cleanup thing a little easier because it's all just there to erase on the one layer. Now I'm gonna add another layer in the clipping mask and I'm gonna zoom in, which is quite important because we're focusing on details now. And in this third phase of Photoshop painting, there are two aspects to keep in mind. We're blending and we're defining. when I say we're defining, what I'm doing is I'm grabbing my shadows and I'm kind of cutting off a dividing line between the aspects of the painting, such as the eye here, just by painting with a smaller brush and being a little fearless with it, and then using my alt click to select my other area and just kind of pushing it out. So it actually divides them without a solid line, and it's quite good because we get to keep the organic feel, but we're also adding a lot of refinement, and we're kind of going to go through this whole character and do that in these areas. Now you'll come to realize that, especially in this phase, alt clicking while you have your brush selected to change between colors is hugely, hugely important, because you're really just going to be alt clicking all the time to constantly change your brush. So for example, here I've used the white to push it out, alt click to select my harder area again, that darker color, and push that out again. And when we're focusing on defining, we can define with both highlights and shadows, and we want to do this with a smaller brush size. So for example, if I want to define this upper lip, I want to make my brush size nice and small, and I want to make a nice clean line, and I also want to kind of make the area of that line a bit smaller by pushing in other areas of the skin. Now, alt clicking doesn't have to only be used on the palette. I can alt click to find all these mid-tones and blend things in with each other, which brings me to the second point of this refining phase. For example, if I find this area too dark, I want to soften the transition between this dark, light, and dark, I can alt click somewhere between those two, have a larger brush size, and very softly paint. Then alt click, softly paint. Alt click, softly paint. If I want to bring the darker area in, alt click in the dark area, softly paint. And we're kind of alt click spreading and mixing. And this is where it actually starts to feel like painting on canvas. We're mixing these colors and getting this really kind of organic look. So I'm going to go ahead and define and blend the rest of this character's skin and face. And we're going to recap and go through the process once I'm done. I hope you found the sped up process interesting, in the sense that watching it, you can actually see that it's a matter of pushing things around, and it's almost like molding clay. If there's any advice I can give on this, it would be to be fearless. Don't worry about, if you make a mistake in an area, just totally painting over that area and starting again. It doesn't matter. Another thing that's good to keep in mind is that once things start looking smooth like this, it's also good to kind of keep an open mind, add a new layer, and start doing some sharp details. So for example, if I select quite a dark shade, darker than my previous darkest, and just kind of add in some of these areas, a much thinner line, not all the way around. I don't want to be overbearing, but also not being too worried about it kind of showing up and making its presence known. And do the same with highlights as well. So for example, here I might want to add a highlight and just kind of add this light little area. That's all it takes. But it really just kind of makes a statement. Sometimes it might be like an area like this. We can use the highlights as a bit of a dividing line. For example, here on the arm, we want to show that this arm is catching the light where the body isn't, and kind of use that to separate them. It's all part of the refining process, and we're kind of evolving with our picture and watching it take shape. We're being very flexible, working with it, making changes to adjust and kind of exploring. And it is something of a difficult method because it's quite unpredictable at times, but I believe the payoff is really good because it's satisfying, it's really organic, and the end result has a really textured painted look. And here we are, ladies and gentlemen. I'm in a place where I'm happy with the skin section of this character. That's the process. That's how I go about painting it. So you can see I've got my swatches there. The other thing I wanted to add at the very end of this is you might have noticed I kind of did a lot of edging around the outside areas with a really light highlight in a kind of a sharp edge. This is what we call rim lighting, and it's really effective to kind of separate characters from the background and add a defining light source that helps kind of round out the silhouette and give things really solid shape of their own. So that's the tutorial today, ladies and gentlemen, on advanced painting in Photoshop. I'm going to go ahead and paint the rest of it and turn it into a bit of a time lapse. So I hope you enjoy watching the rest of the process. Otherwise, thank you for watching, ladies and gentlemen. And until next time, I'll see you later.